We should again give a big hand to the resistance of Honduras and also to this resistance in Paraguay. And si se puede. I always like to put into context and put what we are going to talk about in a visual way. We're going to talk about the coup in Paraguay, and I wanted to for everybody to see where Paraguay is. I know comrades know, but just to see the implications of its situation in Latin America. It is called also the heart of Latin America, and you can see why. It's really in the heart of Latin America. And it's surrounded by Argentina, which seems like cradling Paraguay, and Brazil. And on the north is Bolivia. So it's very, very important, particularly between Argentina and Brazil, which are, you know, particularly Brazil, a powerhouse. I'm sorry, I'm a little frazzled with all this. If we can go to Alex to the second, gracias. This is just some information about Paraguay. It's a bilingual country. 90% of people speak Guarani. Yeah. You know? Hopefully in the United States we'll have like 90% speaking Spanish too eventually. No comment, huh? Okay, it's almost 6.5 million population. But the important thing is the exporting part of Paraguay, which is some places it has the sixth, but according to the U.S. Department of Agriculture said that last year it was the fourth largest exporter of soy. And if you see that Paraguay is not that big compared, you know, to Brazil and Argentina. And it's basically an agricultural country. And also a beef exporter. Many ganaderos, cattle raising people from and landowners from Brazil are in Paraguay, and they even have a term, Brasiguayo, like people from Brazil that have been in, and particularly not just Brazilians who live in Paraguay, but mostly the landowners, the big cattle ranchers. So they say that there are six, according, I think it's Oxfam, says 6 million of people in Paraguay, where there are 12 million cattle heads, cabezas de ganado, how you say? Heads of cattle. So it's like twice the amount of cattle than of people in Paraguay. And that's according to Oxfam. But it shows the importance of Paraguay in the exporting of beef and soy worldwide, but particularly also to Latin America. There are other industries, but I'm not going to go. I'm going to have like an abbreviated presentation so we can move on. But one thing that is very important, and that's why I put it on red, and it's below, it says, according to Oxfam, 2.6% of population hold 85.6% of arable, 85.5% of land, of arable land. And that is an incredible, incredible concentration of wealth and land. And while there are 250,000 campesinos, and that's really a very low figure that they are giving. There are much more than 250,000 campesinos. La otra, por favor. So what happened? I think at this time everybody's might be already familiar with what happened. Just very briefly, last Thursday, just 1 week, 1 week ago, the Senate, you know, there is Congress, like Congress, Representative and Senate, and they are all, the vast majority is by the opposition to Lugo, very right wing. Very few, might be like four, five, six, between senators and representatives, they are pro-Lugo. So it's overwhelmingly an opposition legislator, which is very important, because it's like since 2008, how can a president rule, you know, and do and affect changes within the, you know, the electoral politics with that kind of opposition? And obviously, he hadn't been able to do much. But they held an impeachment hearing and gave Lugo 2 hours to prepare his defense. Of course, he went with the lawyer, his lawyer, and it was impossible. Already, the ruling, the ruling was already done by when they said that they were going to have a hearing. The ruling was already decided. So, the following day, they held the quote unquote the impeachment trial. And as soon as it was the time also that the exterior ministers were meeting in Brazil during the Rio Plus 20. So when they heard about the coup, they all came and they came to the Senate to listen and to try to, you know, have some effect. And they had to leave. And that's including Insulza was there too. They had to leave because they said that there was no way that they were listened to. They had already their minds made up. So it was just, the hearing was just a farce. And also because of the speedy trial, because it was so speedy, but also the grounds that supposedly to be a constitutional ground, I think I put in the next one. The reason for the impeachment, they said, which is in the Constitution, is when a president cannot function well and poor performance, which if that would be a valid, I mean, there wouldn't be any president in the United States. They would all be impeached the following day. Poor performance, are you kidding? You know, so. And these are the reasons. These are the reasons that they use for the impeachment, the poor performance, and the poor performance. And I will explain in the following one what was behind the poor performance, what they refer to the poor performance. But the other was allowing a socialist event with Che Guevara banners in a military facility. The other was that they said that Lugo encouraged peasant, landless peasant to occupy farms, which is the big landowners, the 2.6%. And he was endangering security of the citizens because he didn't do well by combating the guerrilla, the Paraguayan People's Army. So now when they said about the poor performance, the week before, just June 15th, can I get a little bit of water? On June 15th, there was a massacre in, it was like a, like 100 or so kilometers from Asunción. It was very close to the capital. But there is this private, quote-unquote, farm, huge farm, and the campesinos have been occupying the land for 2 to 3 weeks.